In self-development, you're often told, confidence is good and self-doubt is bad. But is that really so? Is it really so that confidence is good and self-doubt is bad? In this speech, I'm going to show you that confidence can be bad and self-doubt can be good. But as always, look out for the extremes, one way or the other. The problem with how we today look at confidence and self-doubt is that self-doubt is inherently bad and it can lead us to overvalue confidence and that leads us to hubris. Hubris is a classical Greek concept. That's why I start with examples from Greek. Prometheus has done many things. But one of the things he did, that he tricked Zeus in accepting the bad parts of the sacrifices for the gods and the good parts for the humans. Very good, of course, for us, but for Prometheus, the result was that an eagle eats his liver for eternity. Then we have Bellerophon. He thought that because he conquered the Chimeron, he was allowed to fly to Olympus and be with the gods. Result, Zeus sent a gadfly that stinked Pegasus and Bellerophon dropped down into a thorn bush and was blind for the rest of his life. A more modern example is Victor Frankenstein. He thought he could defy the laws of nature. It cost him his friends, his family, and his own life. You could think that hubris is an inherently Western flaw, but you would be wrong. If you look to China, China have Qin Shi Huang. He was a great emperor. He created a great empire, but then he wanted the elixir of life. And ironically, that killed him. And after his death, his empire crumbled away. Then there was Zhu Xiang. He preferred wine and women above governing his subjects. And his people were very, very His people got the bad part for that. In the end of his life, he gathered all his treasures around him in his palace and committed suicide by putting everything on fire. In India, you have Ravana. Ravana was loved by the gods. The gods protected him against gods and demons. But he thought humans are nothing, so he didn't need protection against humans. And because the way he treated the gods and Sita, an epic battle started between Ravana and Rama. And because he thought he didn't need protection against humans, Rama could kill him. But what all those examples have in common is they started good. They started great. They were great examples. But because they got full of themselves, they stumbled. So this is why confidence can be bad. Then, why can self-doubt be good? Well, I'm going back to Greek again. Socrates was one of the greatest philosophers of all times. He is my great example. And one of the most famous sayings of Socrates was, I know nothing. If Socrates doubted himself, I surely should doubt myself. Look at the scientific method. The last centuries, we made a lot of leaps. And the scientific method is based on self-doubt. And when we look at Buddhism, in Buddhism, you cannot attain nirvana without great humility. If you look at Taoism, in Taoism, humility is one of the three great great treasures, together with compassion and frugality. And we can use those three very, very much. Also, if you doubt yourself, then if you're on the wrong course, you can change course. Also, if you doubt yourself, you will listen to others. And as the old saying says, two, no more is one. And ten, no even more. But if you fall off yourself, you're not going to use those very useful resources. So I challenge you. Look in yourself. Which part of your life you are much too confident. And you could use a little bit self-doubt and a little bit of humility. And how are you going to implement that? Secondly, which part of your life are you too humble? And how are you going to change that without going to the other extreme? Thank you.